Feijai, they're upside down. Feijai.
I can't.
This is more important.
I can't let go of it.
Whoa, look at the colors. What's in these three bags right here, I would pay to come see it. Hey guys, welcome back to Predatory Fins. Feijai is gonna take a break right now because he killed himself with the stingrays. If you haven't seen part one with all the stingrays that came in, don't forget to go and watch that video. I'll put the link on the description right here. I said the lip. The link on the description right here.
Put your lip on
the... Dude, you got your two best friends right there.
I know, right?
Just waiting for food.
Not yet. I gotta eat first.
But we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17 boxes to unpack. And I'll tell you what. What's in these three bags right here, you can't see it yet. You can't see it yet, but it's something that, honestly, I would pay to come see it. And it's gonna be in the showroom. So if you guys wanna see what's behind me, make sure you stay to the end of the video. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe. I've been doing good and asking for that now because we need it. But I'm very excited because animals like this don't come very often and they're gonna be a great addition for the showroom. Enough said. Feijai is gonna take his greasy fingers a little break, and I'm gonna, what box? You wanna start with a bang?
Let's do 12.
12.
Not so much of a bang, but.
Damn, this box is heavy as shit. Heavier than the Brazil boxes. We're gonna start with box 14, because he was already on top. These right here are Indo tarpons. Dude, they actually came in a good size. Not small, not huge. What would you say, six inches?
Yeah. There's some a couple of smaller ones.
Yeah.
But better than last time. Last time it was a little bit too big and it made our freight kind of hefty. So this works out pretty good.
All right, so we have a whole
six
box
bags.
Of Indo tarpons. We're gonna go ahead and start acclimating them. And you already know, jump into another box. All right, last bag of tarpons. All look pretty healthy. And if you guys like tarpons, this is better for a smaller setup. Because he doesn't get huge like an Atlantic tarpon. Box one, it was decent. I enjoyed box one. Let's see box. Are these clouded archers?
Yes, these are the Burmese archers. Burmese clouded
archer. Oh, wow. Look at this, guys. Burmese clouded archer. These are actually pretty cool. I want to have an exhibit tank for them in there because when there's a bug, they will spit the water on the bug to get their food, which is pretty cool. But they're all jumping like crazy right now.
I wonder why. Maybe are they scared or jump
out? Yeah, look, now, see? So we're going to go take care of these guys right now, make sure that they're good and they're going to live, and we're going to jump into another box. All right. Last bag of archerfish.
Where's 13?
Right there they are. So what's happening right now, for those of you that are new to the channel, this water is really cold. With medicine, little by little, our water that's warmer is gonna come in the tank. It's gonna overflow and change the water by itself. We found this is the best way to acclimate these fish. We're not stressing them out, and we're acclimating pretty slow. So we're not just acclimating the temperature, we're acclimating pH and water parameters as well. 13. With number
lucky
three.
13.
Let's see how lucky these
13.
Are. They're well bagged.
Can't even see the fish.
I know.
Like a ghost.
So white.
I just see a black eye.
Oh, these are the platinum archer?
Yep. There we go.
Dude, this is insane. We need to have a tank and a showroom for these guys.
Yep, definitely.
This is amazing. So are these Bermudes or regular archer?
Hard
to tell, right? Because they're platinum.
I don't know. I have to ask. Well, guys, I didn't care, as long as it was a platinum archer.
Yeah, like this is pretty crazy. Let's go ahead and open one so you can see.
We'll put it next to the other one so people can see the difference.
Wait till you see it in the tank. Let's go put them away. We'll be right back. All right, this is a more common fish. These guys are the red-tailed tiger shovel nose hybrid.
Oh.
It's gonna be a little hard to see. Good size fish, about 6 inches.
Is it, really?
Yeah.
There's only a few pieces, right?
Yeah. Two bags, but they came in looking pretty healthy. We're gonna put them away, jump into another box.
Ready?
Yep. All right, wild fish eye. Oh, sorry. Wild fish eye is taking care of the fish there. These are, what are they, blue timers here?
Yeah.
Blue timers here. So they might have a golden look right now, but as they grow, they'll have more of a blue sheen to their body.
We were offered the adult ones, but it was one per box.
Dude, I thought we were getting at least one.
I guess he couldn't get it.
Yeah.
But it was like this big, 18 inches.
All blue.
All blue, amazing.
You guys want one of those? We can pre-order for you. So let's start helping them because I see one here sideways. Everybody else looking good. Let's get this done and move on. So what's the difference between these and other types of Mercier's?
It's the blue variant. With Mercier's, there's many different colored morphs. There's gold, there's red, there's blue.
But right? They also come from different parts.
Yeah, different parts of the world. There's from Southeast Asia, from India. So far, out of all the different types of Mercier's, this is one of my favorite because they actually show decent color at a young age. A lot of other Mercier's need to get really big. So even though these are blue Mercier's, they show a lot of gold on their scales at a very young age. So you get to start enjoying them much, much sooner.
Then after that, they turn blue.
Yes, they'll get, so where you, I don't know if you can see it, John. When you get tight on the scales, there's that like that iridescent color, and then you see there's like a slight line of blue, like
look,
a faint iridescent.
This guy jumped to the other side.
You see that part of the scale right there? That turns blue. And then the outer part is gold. So it's a combination of like a half gold and blue scale, which makes it really, really gorgeous fish. This was one that he held back from that last batch for himself.
So this is a box. You got to get close here, John. Bro, this looks like drugs.
It's not drugs.
No, but the way it's packed.
It's like little sausages.
So this is only one. Bro, we didn't keep one last time. We should have kept him.
We're going to keep this one.
Okay, this is a leopard ripsaw hybrid. It's a mixture of a ripsaw and a tiger shovel nose. Last time we sold all of them and we regret it, but we're gonna keep this guy for the showroom. We're getting a lot of fish for the showroom, bro. We gotta get that showroom done.
Well, it's time
all now these girls here might have to open OnlyFans to help out because we don't have enough money to build that thing. What else you have in there?
Something different, but I don't think we can see them. These are betas. Can you see?
Here.
These are candy betas.
But they don't have to be separate?
Yeah, they do. So that's why. Just open one to show them.
I know. I didn't do it.
Ooh. Let me get a cup.
Wow. Actually, that looks pretty nice.
Yeah, these are really nice ones.
Last time I had these, they weren't that nice.
What?
Boss, this is a beta fish.
It's like electric.
There you go.
Blue.
Ready?
The fish store special.
Told you, we got a lot of crazy fish in the shipment, but behind me over there is the craziest.
You can show them this one. I wouldn't even know what to call it.
Okay, so this is an alligator gar. The body on the bottom and the sides are white, but the top is a little gray.
Yeah, so they're supposed to be platinums, but it could be stress from the shipping too. So we'll wait and see. Let them settle in, because we know like the other platinum, sometimes the back gets a little bit of a light gray.
So let's put them over here. Yeah, so like the top looks normal, right? Like a normal fish. And then look at the sides. Super white. And the bottom of the fish is also very white. No spots though. So it might turn back, we'll see. We're just gonna keep them in here. We can't sell as a platinum unless it turns full white. So these are flounder horn.
Oh, those are flounder?
Yeah, those are flounder horn.
Well, let's not do those yet.
So it's gonna be hard to see, but what type are they?
Man, I
red, forgot. Red dragon?
Yeah, red dragon.
Red dragon. Okay, so we got whole two bags of red dragons.
It's supposed to be mixed. We're supposed to get the Thai silks also. Let's see. It's supposed to be half and half. Let's pray for Thai silk.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh,
there we go.
Dude, look at the size of that cock.
It's a golf ball right there.
Oh my God, that looks ridiculous.
Nice.
All right, so we got Thai silk, red dragon, bunch of baiters. Individual pictures of them all soon. Fijai is gonna take care of it.
Man, that's a lot of work. I got the rays, I got these flower horns, and the betas probably too, right?
People like to pick
yeah.
one. Yeah, so you made the order. All right, let's acclimate these guys. and jump into another box.
15, 21, and then 28. Okay.
Whoa. All right, so this is something different. These guys.
These are the apagons.
Apagon?
Yeah.
Okay.
The one that gets really big.
So how can we tell the difference?
You know what?
Like I'm between not sure. The Damara, Apagon?
I'm not sure. We just have to trust our supplier.
Okay, so we got a whole box. I mean, they look chrome. Last time we had the Danema, remember?
Last time they said it was Apagon also, but you said it was Danema. So, but it was hard to tell last time because they were much smaller.
So we're just gonna have to look when it's in the tank and find out. It came in as Apagon, but.
Because we got Apagon from them before, a long time ago when I was still in LA, but they were really big, they were like that.
Yeah.
But they didn't do good in the shipping. So since then, I didn't want to bring it again. And these, they got them and they grew it for us.
All that sound that you hear right now is them cutting all the stingray tails off. The barbs.
All right, let's get them in the tank so that everyone can see it better.
All right. Oh, I have the whole tank of Apagon. I think we only had one little casualty. All the other ones look okay. Well, he's still moving, so I'm gonna leave him in there. Open this water. Oh.
Either one.
Technical difficulties. Okay, another box. These right here are regular tiger shovel nose. So last time we import the tiger shovel nose, we had the tigrinum, which is the one with more stripes. These guys are more like spotted. So this is the common type, the fasciatum. Let's go ahead and put them away and start acclimating them. I see some of them sideways, so hopefully we can save them all out.
Why is the boss on
hell? The boss
right
here?
Yeah.
He's made of air. He's not here right now. It's a delusion.
Wow.
Why Wait, delusion or illusion?
Illusion.
What's a delusion?
You're delusional. You've got no right thoughts. Oh.
He doesn't even like to be on camera. This is the first appearance of Mr. Look, if I go somewhere with them, way, and then we're trying to find which way to go, but like, yo, wait.
If they got married and they took Kevin's last name, he would be Weiwei.
So don't become Weiwei, okay?
Oh. We're almost there, folks. Whew. Okay. You guys gonna agree with me. These are little Feijai fish. Isn't it? Look at the head.
Oh yeah.
1000% Feijai. It's just not round, it's very thin to be a Feijai, but the head is like similar. Do they just call humphead fish?
Humphead glass fish?
Glass fish. Really cool. You actually can see right through them. All right, so these right here are, oh, if you guys said the name, I don't remember anymore.
But it's. These are
not Dorados.
They're
actually really pretty. Look at the markings on these things.
You gotta be careful with loaches because right on their face, they have like spikes come up right here. But look at the markings. Pretty, pretty loach. So we have a bag of them. We're gonna start acclimating these guys and jump into another box. Mommy or daddy? Wait! Mommy or daddy?
What?
Now he even going to the fan. Mama!
Mama!
Blue. You prefer mama, bro? Does she play SARS with you? She doesn't play SARS with you. I play SARS with you.
Mama!
All right, let's see what these are. Albino clowns. Okay, good size. Last time they came in really well. This time they look really healthy. All the bags are moving well. All right, we got some albino clowns. Good. So let's put these guys away and jump to another box. We have four boxes there.
And throw this away.
One more here. I think we already looked at this one. And then we have the main box right there. So let's keep going. All right, whole tank of albino clowns. All looking pretty good. All right. Let's go jump to another box.
What is it?
Oh, yeah. Look at this. Coop, you can't figure out which one's bigger. Is the big one here? Whoa, look at the colors. Dude, the colors are so vibrant on this fish. This is a giant fire eel. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's it, 6 total? Dude, there's some big boys in here. All right, but I want to open this guy so you guys can see how big he is. Might have to be a keeper. We always say that when I'm selling it. Double bag. Dude. Bro, no, you have to see it. Look compared to my hand. Look how thick this fire eel is. I know, insane. Super docile. Oh, dude, I made love to this fish. I need it now. Just like the avatar, just by touching it, you know, we got a connection. And that's it, this is ours. I got other ones here for you. And you're gonna see when we put them in a tank. Let's go. This is a nice big one here too, look. Damn. And boy, thick, boy. One more?
One last one.
Still decent size. Wow. So just so you have an idea, this tank is 24 inches. Look, he's literally from here to the end of the tank. That's some big fire eels in there. All right. I honestly can't tell you guys right now which tank is my favorite from this batch. We have a lot of cool fish and we still got buck. Oh, look at that, look at that. See, if I didn't pay attention. These guys, they jump. So make sure if you get one, put a lid on your tank.
Any more behind the tank?
Yep, there's more back there. You gotta go on the other side, Fijai. There's
wait,
one right there on the floor.
Wait,
save the fish, wait. Save, kick him. No, don't kick him.
Where is it?
Oh no, every second counts. Ah! Good job, Way. Is there more? I think the stingray video. Okay. Oh yeah. NTT datnoids. And this is like the perfect size.
Oh, they came in great.
Yeah, right?
The last time they came in lying down. These are nice.
Come in all standing up. Okay. I like this size more than the last size. They're a little bit too big. This is like perfect size. That's what Fijai said, right?
Perfect size.
Yeah. All right, so let's acclimate these guys and see what's next. Man, this is a good shipment. I don't even want to know what the shipment costs. See that face? That's the face of expense. Yo, these are more Mercier's.
That's a different type of Mercier.
Okay, this is a different type of Mercier here. So this one is a what, Fijai?
This is a Mercier from Burma. It's called the, let me see, Stevensoni, right? Or how would you say that?
Stevensoni Mercier, yeah.
Stevensoni Mercier.
Okay.
Supposed to be a rare one. Not seen in the hobby very often.
It looks different.
Yes, you can see right away, it's got the black dot on the tail.
The water's cold.
Nice color scales too.
Yeah, but once they acclimate, it might even look different than this.
Yes, I tried looking up online what they would look like. You can't even find information on it. That's how rare it is.
So this is pretty cool then.
Yeah.
All right. Now we don't have any tanks for it.
Nope.
Nope. I'm gonna go to the crazy box and I'll be like, they're not moving. Fijai, they're upside down. Fijai.
What?
They're upside down. No, I can't show you. They're upside down. They're upside down, bro.
Okay, I can't.
This is more important.
I can't let go of this. This is
I'm just kidding.
Give me a net.
Yo, did your heart skip a beat for a second?
I didn't believe you. That's why I was like.
We're gonna move some of this fish to make space for the other boxes that we have. So we're gonna start with the Mercier's, but look, you can see already the blue color start coming on. So yeah, they keep jumping. We're gonna go ahead and move them out to start jumping into another box.
I'll just turn it towards you.
Yeah, we couldn't touch this guy. His eyes are messed up.
This is why it's hard to bring kids here. Look at this. Look at that move, ready? Oh, there you go. Mommy loves that. We need a playground here, dude.
Start acclimating these guys. They're more of the rare Mercers. We're gonna put them here where the other ones were.
Oh, you see the stripe and the dot?
Mm-hmm.
They also look like they have a tall body too.
Yeah. And I'm looking at the scales. They got nice scale difference. Look at this one. Look how shiny this one is.
Yeah, let's see what they look like once they acclimate too. That was a good shipment for John. I'm proud
so
of
far,
you.
So far.
So, unfortunately, there was a whole bag of bamboozers, but the water was too cold. This is what's left. Sucks. But we got a couple of smaller ones. And then here, we're gonna have alligator gars, I would say around 3 to 4 inches. So we're gonna go ahead and acclimate these. And then we have one more box here. Might as well just show it to you guys. We can start acclimating. I don't know what these are.
Oh, these are, I think these are pinstripe dumbas. They're actually pretty cool.
Hey, these pinstripe dumbas?
No.
There's something else, right?
They're not pinstripe dumbas.
What are they? So these are, they look like a saltwater fish.
Yeah, well actually, it's a Madagascar cichlid, and a lot of fish coming out of Madagascar is endangered because their environment has been, what's the word?
Destroyed.
Destroyed, I guess. And the only time you'll find these type of cichlids is in a captive bred situation. So this is my first time ever seeing it. I the first time I even heard of it.
Really
when
cool
I
fish.
Saw it on the list, I was like, wow.
Gotta get it.
Yep.
All right. So we're gonna acclimate these guys, start showing you everything that came in, and jump into the mystery box. All right, guys, after a long day, we're finally not done. Not done at all. Well, this is not even half of the way, right?
Because we still got part one.
Part one, we gotta put it away, acclimate the fish.
Shoot them.
Yeah, feed them, you know, put them on the website. It's still a lot of.
Yes, this is only the first, this is the second step. Ordering it was the first step.
Yeah.
And now this is the second step.
So the shipment came in pretty good. There's a couple DOAs. Some fish came in a little weak, like this guy here, but we're giving him a chance to come back around. Let's start over here with the monster fire eels. There's a giant. There's at least two giant ones in there, but they're all pretty big. I say pretty close to 24 inches or 24 inches. Here we have the albino clowns, around 5 inches. These came in as apagon catfish. We're gonna double check and make sure that that's what they are. But we have from 4 inches all the way up to 6 inches. Tiger shovel nose, just regular tiger shovel nose. Regular red tails. Oh, there's one guy in there that didn't do well. Take him out. Here is something a little more rare that they might jump out. What are these again, Fijai?
The Stevensoni Mercers.
Stevensoni Mercers. So I never seen them before, but looks like an amazing fish. Fijai said it's pretty hard to come by, so we're gonna have to take good care of them. The bamboozer bag didn't do very well. You see a couple floaters there, so we're not even gonna put them on the website. Then we have the humpheads, and what are the loaches?
Kobutai.
Kobutai?
Yeah, kobutai.
Kobutai loaches. There's loaches. A nice size ones in there. We got some NTTs, all came in really nice. Good size, about 3.5 inches. Clouded archer, all of them amazing. Didn't lose any of them. Doing very well. And then we have the group of platinums. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 platinum archer fish. Now, we're most likely gonna put them for sale because by the time our showroom is ready, we can probably order more. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, so they're gonna be for sale. Alligator gars, around 3.5, 4 inches.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And these are something rare as well. Fijai, what are the name of these guys again?
Maculatus. We'll call them the Maculatus Dumbas. I don't know.
Maculatus Dumba.
Like pinstripe Dumba.
But this is the first time we've seen them for sale.
Yeah.
And we brought them in. So a couple really, you did good with this order. But we're ready to finally reveal the mystery box.
Oh, I thought you were closing out the video already.
No, we can't. They're waiting for this box. So let me put this guy in here. Now, there's 3 fish here. We're keeping 2.
We haven't decided yet. We'll see.
We might keep all 3.
Yeah.
Maybe you can breed them. So by that hint right there, you guys already know it's gonna be a stingray, but check this out.
Let's just open this one.
Look at this, dude. Leopard whiptail
stingray.
Can you catch the color on that, John? If you get in there, it's like a purplish blue. Yeah, there you go.
Dude, this is insane.
It's ridiculous.
And the size of the tail curves all the way around. But what really impressed me is the color of the babies. So we're hoping that we have two females and one male. Look at that. Dude. And these are probably illegal even in Florida.
Yeah.
Because they're not Potamotrigon, right?
No,
Himantura. Wait, how do you say that?
Himantura. Potamotrigon.
Potamotrigon. So these are Himantura. Look, dude, I'm in love with these babies. Now let's go to moment of truth. Let's see if they're male or female. Ready? This one right here. I don't see the huevos.
Female. I already know the sex.
Female, dude. Yeah. Female. All right, all right, all right. We like females. This one here. Male, okay, one and one. Okay. What about big boy? Oh, please be a big girl. Please be a big girl. Why don't you lift up that bag?
I know what it is. It's a girl.
You saw it already?
I was told. So if you sex those two.
Yep, it's a girl.
All right.
Dude, we gotta keep them then. Yep. We have two girls, one boy, and you guys will be able to see these beautiful animals when you come here to the showroom and when we do our videos as well. So guys, if you're happy with the shipment, just like us, with these amazing animals, please, like I said, don't forget to what, Fitcher? Don't forget to what?
Like, share, subscribe.
And buy fish.
A big thumbs up for the video.
No, screw the thumbs up. Buy fish.
Oh, buy fish.
Yeah,
oh,
buy
yeah.
fish
They know
out.
That about me already. Okay. Yeah, I always push buy fish.
Then thumbs up, thumbs up. But I think this shipment came in amazing. But then we also have another shipment coming in with some really cool fish, right?
Yes, you lost me because there's so many.
So if you want to stay tuned, Predatory Fins, don't forget, we'll keep doing these unboxing videos as we have them come in. And hopefully when the store is ready and when we have all our big tanks, we can do other types of videos for you guys as well. Great job on the shipment. You did well. These are my favorite stingrays of all time. One last time, bro. Look at the pattern on the tail. Can you zoom in on the tail? Look at that. These are gonna be like our babies. We gotta like really take care of these fish and hopefully grow them out. Do they get really big?
I don't think so, actually.
So they're not giants?
I don't think so. I did a little research on them, and I think 15, 16 inches.
So that's not too
tall. But it doesn't sound right, though, because this type is supposed to get big, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
So we'll see. But we got some really nice ones here, and we're going to keep you guys updated on this. Dude, we already have a lot of really cool stuff for the showroom.
Yeah.
We don't talk about it enough. We got sharks. We got more sharks on the way.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
It's probably the other ones. Okay. I think I know what it is.
No, I haven't told them about the sharks. I don't even know if they're coming, but hopefully they're coming soon. We gotta put this fish away. We'll see you guys next time. Say bye, say bye,
All
say
right,
bye.
Take care, guys. See you next time.